under these directives and the SOPs assessed by the president in the last press conference, I think it's going to be hard for boxing to resume activities because we do not have that kind of resource envelope to resume the activities, and wouldn't want to give false hope to our athletes because it doesn't make so much sense to us as a federation and also to them as individuals and also to our clubs, because you're going to find clubs living on people's small savings. So now you cannot ask them, people are struggling to get equipment, they're struggling to get gloves, and you're asking them to come and pay 300,000 every single time and it's going to compete. So it doesn't make any sense, and we don't see us resuming as soon as we had anticipated. The way forward is for National Council and the Ministry of Sports and Education to engage further with the Ministry of Health, to engage further the central government, and let them know that what they are suggesting is unrealistic for sport and cannot apply for sport, maybe save for FUFA, which gets maybe so much money from the government, but the remaining other sports, maybe about like 98% of them, I don't think they can stand by those set directives from the president. So there is need to re-advocate, to re-present ourselves to the president that what you're talking about is not practical, and this is how we hope we could do it. My idea would be, let's just treat sports people the same way we are treating all other Ugandans. Test for the temperatures, sanitize, keep social distancing, and then we monitor the environment as it is at that particular time.